Have you ever thought about what it would be like to lose power? Not for a couple hours, but for several months? How would you survive? Where would you get your daily water or food? How would you communicate? So many aspects of our daily lives depend on electricity. It affects our economy and national security. The electric grid is one of the critical infrastructures identified by Homeland Security Presidential Directive 7.
Directly tied to our national economy. About 60% of our GDP is directly tied to electric power. And so a long sustained outage affects our national economy as well as, of course, national security.
The 2003 blackout. Most power restored in 48 hours. Estimated $10 billion in economic losses. Annual power outages. Economic losses, $100 billion. Several other critical infrastructures, such as transportation, communications, and water, have direct ties to the electric grid and depend on the grid in order to provide their services. A long-term power outage has the potential to be catastrophic. Such an outage could be caused by man-made physical attacks, cyber attacks, or natural disasters, such as solar storms. The transmission grid in the United States is currently the largest in the world with over 80,000 miles of extra high voltage transmission lines. The transmission grid is a long-haul delivery system used to transport power from the generation stations to the distribution network. EHV transformers are critical components of the transmission grid, transforming voltage from one level to another for transport along the transmission grid. Without them, the grid can't function. These transformers are subject to a number of vulnerabilities. They are extremely large, making transportation a challenge. They have long lead times and other procurement challenges, sometimes with a 12 to 24 month delay. And they can take several weeks or even months to transport and install. The recovery transformer is a solution that is proven to reduce recovery time by more than 75% from several months to less than 1 week.
Transformer is designed to meet industry standards. We designed this based on traditional transformer technology. So this transformer, the recovery transformer, is going to last 30 years and it's going to provide reliable service. The key to it is the modularity. It's the taking a three-phase transformer, turning it into three single-phase transformers, and then taking all the components off of that transformer and making it modular. That's how we get the weight down.
From the ground up, it's designed to be highly transportable and fast to install. Looking at the each box behind me does 200 MVA, that's 200 million watts. That's roughly about one-fifth or one-sixth the size of a nuclear reactor, a big nuclear power plant.
To prove the recovery transformer concept, the team conducted a pilot demonstration that included the transportation, installation, assembly, commissioning, and energization of the transformer in less than 1 week. The exercise begins with the ancillary equipment, such as the turrets, bushings, and control cabinets, loaded onto flatbed trailers, beginning the journey to the site right away. This allows the utility crew on the receiving end to pre-position and test equipment before the transformers arrive. In the meantime, the transformers, which are stored full of oil, are drained, the COPS tanks are removed, and secured to a trailer containing the cooling equipment. And the transformers are secured to low-boy trailers. The transformers drive on the route provided by the state permitting agencies with their escorts. At the substation, the ancillary equipment has already arrived, been tested, and pre-positioned by the utility crew. Once the transformers arrive, the first two units are positioned by a crane. The team also tested a unique design for easy transport on the third unit, known as the MA-65. This allows the transformer to be transported on a sled, which the trailer can attach to either side of for transport and detach after positioning in the correct location. The sled also acts as a foundation for the transformer.
And we set two of the units using a 200-ton crane. The units, by the way, weigh about 125,000 pounds apiece. We used a crane to set two of the units, but the third unit, we used a specially designed trailer that resembles, for those of you familiar with a snobble car, rail car, it resembles a snobble car but used over the road as opposed to over the rail.
Once the transformers are positioned, crews begin the assembly process, which includes connecting bushings, control cabinets, lightning arresters, and more. The oil service takes place once key elements of the transformer have been assembled.
Processing on these units has been condensed somewhat because of the nature of the units compared to a traditional auto. We're able to oil service these units in basically a little under a day, say 2 days, just rounding it off with our set time, where a traditional auto transformer can take as much as 3 weeks to oil service.
Crew then conducts final testing of the equipment, controls, and protection systems before energizing the units by closing the switches. The end result is a beautiful hum we hear when the units come online and begin carrying load to customers. The exercise was completed in 6 days, a record time for installing such a transformer. The recovery transformer has the potential to significantly minimize the effects of a long-term outage on our grid, strengthening America's security and resiliency.